What's going on, dudes? County Gaines back yet. So today we got little Dicky, Russel, Westbrook on a farm. So this is Drake. I've never heard this song ever before, FYI. But this is off Drake's. This is a Drake sample called Pound Cake. Even the board here, the background is Pound Cake. It's like Drake. So we're going to get straight into this one, guys. Like the video, comment down below what you guys want to see next. Also subscribe, hit the Patreon link, all that good stuff, guys. Love you guys all. And let's get him, man. This one's gonna be long, guys, so I definitely wanna see what little Dicky's gonna be bringing to the board here, because that last song that he had, it was sick. Never listened to really too much little Dicky at all, only a couple songs, so let's get it. See if we can catch every bar here. Saying cream, everything around me, that's a Wu-Tang Clan.
Ain't no doubt about it, shit is coming. And I'm just praying that little Dicky love it. Always told myself that this the type of shit I wanted. I was being honest, even made a promise. Not with anybody else, this was in the conscience. Talking to my fucking self, that's a little bonkers. I know, I still got a lot of shit to conquer. I hope that ain't even my concern though. You know I'll be working till I get what I deserve. Whatever totems I can personally, you know I'ma earn those. This ain't even about some shit up on a checklist. This about the fact that I'm about to test this.
Hey, this is fire. He said I'm gonna be the best, man. You know, this ain't about a checklist. Obviously, he's not talking about I don't want the money. I just want
to
be the best.
I'm about to figure out what my best is. I can't avoid it because now your boy invested. And I ain't got a choice except to smile and accept it. Pretty reckless. Pretty restless, cuz I've lived my life expecting love to come the second my attempt was done. And yeah, I guess to some extent I was correct because I'm getting buzzed. But now I'm about to be ubiquitous. Look at it.
I love that flow. I'm gonna get my buzz because any second I'm gonna be ubiquitous. Ubiquitous means rampant, like it's like widespread. So, like if you know, that thing that we had recently for the last 2 years, that was ubiquitous, everybody had it. Everyone has it. That's what ubiquitous means.
To some extent, I was correct because I'm getting buzzed, but now I'm about to be ubiquitous. Look it up.
So he even says, look it up. Not a lot of people would know what ubiquitous means. I love English language, guys. That's the only subject I was good at in school was English. You know, same as Eminem. Not saying anything though, but yeah, English was my favorite subject in school, guys. For real.
Yeah, or that's at least what I'm assuming. But as alluded to, reality is looming. And now your dude about to make a move and take the truth and hope to God that when he threw that what he thought about is proven. But honestly, I'm not afraid that it's delusion. I'm hot enough to where I know it's not illusion. But obviously, I've been finding this confusing. This ain't even close to what I thought I would be doing. Don't get me wrong, I was born to be big. But I always figured it would be the comedy thing. So I started rapping just to see what drama it brings. But big dogs from sitcoms would holler at me. And as the time passed, I rhymed faster lines. Crafted was high class as I master my crafting.
Bro, his flow is class right there. That flow is sick. I haven't heard from Lil Dicky in years, so where's it been?
Damn, who'd have thought it'd get like this? Back in 2010, music wouldn't make that list. I'm talking Ooh. Top 5 to 10 strengths with no wings. I would not lie, my pen dry with no ink. Or that's at least what I thought till I clawed and scratched a pen till I saw a line draw. Then I could have let bygones be bygones, but I really wanted to rhyme till my line drawn. Like where the fuck is my peak at? Not brown, but I make it pop, then I beat that. Not crowned yet, but I don't think I decreed that. Not loud, but you know I'm ready to tweet that.
Damn, not loud, but I'm ready to tweet that. That's fire, bro. This is obviously, guys, I'm not breaking down these bars too much because you guys already know what's going on here.
Really hope I'm ready to be that. Now you see him where D's at. Cause even though I'm softer than the tissue, I ain't nothing to sneeze at. I'm smarter, where the fuck.
Bro. Knowing where the tissue's at ain't nothing to sneeze at.
And where D's at, cause even though I'm softer than the tissue, I ain't nothing to sneeze at. I'm smarter where the fuck your degrees at. And I ain't harder, but I'm hotter, homie, where the fuck your degrees at. I'm about to come in and desaturate the sheet wrap today and evap.
Degrees, where your degrees at, hotter than degrees at, saturated as well, crazy.
Separate the feedback I hate, I elaborate at a later date. But I'm getting off the point with the player hate. What the fuck was I saying? Yeah, I'm kind of a slave to my ambition. I ain't quitting till my shit is appraised and I-
Yo, that hit me deep, bruh. I'm a slave to my ambition and I'm not quitting till it's appraised. You know, until people appraise it, you know, appraise it's being seen. Also, he's saying appraise it, when people appraise it. Bro, these lyrics, boy, they're fire.
Yeah, I'm kind of a slave to my ambition. I ain't quitting till my shit is appraised. And I admit it, nice. I predicted where I finish is crazy. But that just means that it's further away. So, heard about the work until he turned in his grave. It's really burdensome when earning something's fun for the day. But I'm concerned about the burning out from upping the stakes. I'm always...
Like, people talk about, oh, reaction videos ain't working shit. Guys, everyone on YouTube, Irish people, they all do the same shit reacting. It's just to, like, different stories, like news stories. Everyone's doing reaction videos to stuff. It's just how you, you know, how you chop it up and how you do it. I obviously am obsessed with music. That's what I know. I know music, like... Rap IQ 100, fitness IQ 100, everything else, zero. So that's what I'm doing.
Always up in the stakes. I'm taking dinner meetings in New York, always up for the stakes. We exploring...
I'm taking dinner meetings up in New York. I'm always up for the stakes. Obviously, Ruth, Chris, big steakhouse in New York.
The discussion is great. They assuring me that when I'm more elite, I'll be secure and amazed. But this isn't insecurity, man. Like, this the opposite of that. Confidence and fade. My biggest problem is I can't honestly relax. Because inside of me a damn odyssey and axe. And I made a promise that I can't be the body to stop. And I think I need a lobotomy. Little Dicky the prophecy. Little bit of anomaly. Not a commodity. Not a facade or a lot of the comedy. Prodigies commonly brought up with Dicky. Feeling...
Bro, that's... Bro, his bars are crazy in this, guys. His bars are crazy in this.
I need to stop and think I need a lobotomy. Little Dicky the prophecy. Little bit of anomaly. Not a commodity. Not a facade or a lot of the comedy. Prodigies commonly brought up with Dicky. Feeling weird. Let me think of an analogy. Just imagine for a second. What if Russell Westbrook never knew his own mentality? Grew up...
Oh, bro. I actually forgot to say, guys. I need to make a... What if Russell Westbrook didn't know his own mentality? Russell Westbrook's one of the toughest dudes in the NBA. His mentality is crazy, guys. He's, in my opinion, and I think I'll say this publicly right now. He is the best athlete in the world, in my opinion. Apart from a couple of people like Vic Beasley, few people like that. He's one of the best, if not the best athlete in the entire world, in my opinion. You know, 6'3", you know, 200 pounds, 205 pounds, but just able to jump crazy, explosive, fast, strong. Like, he's one of the best ever. His mentality for exercise and pushing it, he pushes it 100% every single game. 4 days a week, crazy, crazy stuff, guys.
On a farm where the biggest commonality was people that conformed to the ruralist localities. To Russell, though, it was nothing but normality. And he really nice up on the plow in actuality. Everybody liked the kid and dug his personality. And so the mutuality was somewhat rationality. So then your man made a plan of practicality. Not even a plan, it was more of a formality. Get a little land and attend to his vitality. Then raise a little fam till it all became finality. The strategy was just to stay in the course and do your chores. When you're happy, you ain't need to abort. Never explored enough unless he roll around on his horse. The one day he was up on his horse. That's when...
Bro, he's basically saying that he grew up in a little small town. He became amazing. He said, you know, once you get happy, guys, you don't need to stay the you don't need to swerve off course. Like, a lot of times when people get famous, Conor McGregor, etc., they stop doing what they love, guys. And I think that takes away your passion. That makes people, like, kill themselves because they're only doing one thing they love. Like, I love this shit. I don't think I'll ever be doing anything else. It's just the greatest thing in the world. Like, apart from working out, I might do reactions to workouts or talk about working out and stuff like that. But if you start swerving off your course, you will be upset, man. And you won't make any progress.
When he went past the porch, the path he normally passes forth was fast and short, was after more, went faster north, the master lord, a master more. And Jesus then discovered Christ. The court. He like, yeah, let me down, Tim. Hop.
He's saying Russell Westbrook grew up in the countryside, then he went further up north, you know, northern states, and developed it and found the court, you know, rest is history.
Off looking puzzled at the round rim, saw a ball up in the corner on the ground, and Russell started dribbling and giggling, astounded. Then he shot a brick and then a brick and then he downed it, and when he hit it, Russell listened to the fucking sound friction up in the swish make, and he was confounded. Because he knew that he had found him. But right now, it was still for the fun. Just a way to kill the time when the farming was done. Then the walking turned to running, and the hopping turned to jumping and dunking. And Russell had to keep coming because the youngin' was fucking disgusting and loving and running. And all of a sudden, the public started to come in abundance and fuck with him because he was butter and hungry, hungry, cause stories are glory. Not normally for people like him. Then the word got around up to ESPN. And they flying Russell down to compete in the gym. Bunch of grown men looking to belittle the kid because the those men ball was the reason to live. And the goats, they've been all in since they was kids. So this goat on the motherfucker looked like a dick. And even though Russell knows that, he doesn't submit.
Yeah, so obviously everyone says that Russell Westbrook's super cocky and looks like a dickhead, but he said he's not going to give up himself just because other people say that. Oh man, mentality 100.
Chills with a grin, and then the game start, and this motherfucker take charge, make it rain hard, D up on these bitches, making children of men, looking better than his predecessors ever could get, turn the animosity to respect, and then the Thunder called him, said they heard a lot about the balling, told him that they want to get involved in, showed him all the shit that you can get up in the league, it's so appalling, Oklahoma City in the autumn, hella pretty awesome, everybody laud him, every bitty looking like they really fucking falling, condominium is so legitimate, it's sprawling, and this motherfucker on the court straight balling, cash, hey. All up in that ass, lolling at the past, like where the fuck would I be at up on the other path, right, if I never stumble upon the game and think of that life,
nice.
Shit, who taking care of my farm?
Oh bro, I love this song.
Who taking care of my farm?
He's basically saying like, you know, what would have happened if I took a different path, if I didn't try and attempt this crazy shit by becoming an NBA player, it's impossible to join the NBA, guys. If I didn't attempt to do it, where would I be, you know? He's basically saying take risks, take chances, take business risks. Oh, I love it, bro. Absolutely fire.
I really
love
that farm. K, 500 million, now that's a pound cake, according to Jay-Z and Drake. But greatness ain't about K.
Obviously, talking about the money, 500 million, that's what they have at that time. I think Jay-Z is a billionaire now, though. Crazy.
Yeah.
Obviously, with the Wu-Tang sample from Cream at the end there, everything, dollar bill, everything rules around us. Russell Westbrook on a farm, Lil Dicky, 28 million views, absolutely crazy, guys. Hope you guys like that, man. I'll see you guys in the next one real soon. Peace.